VocalTune is Entrack's pitch correction and manipulation plugin. It's great to fix pitch incorrections on vocals or other melodic parts. Let's listen to the vocal on this track.
Ghost in the mirror, never say no. Give me something I can feel, something I can touch.
It's good, but there are some subtle tuning imperfections.
Everyone's consuming, nobody's
got. Let's see how we can fix them using VocalTune.
Spirit of the mind, tell me what do you.
First of all, let's zoom into our vocal track a little. And let's also solo it out so we can focus on the vocal. Now let's apply VocalTune. Click on an Insert Effect slot and select VocalTune from Entrack's Effects. Before we start processing the sound, let's take a look at the plugin's interface. The plugin will modify the incoming signal's pitch and snap it to the notes of the chromatic scale or any other scale we select. The extent to which the incoming pitch will be affected can be set from the correction amount knob. The correction speed knob will control the attack or speed with which the correction will act on the sound. Lower speed values will preserve the sound's natural attack, while higher ones will create more artificial or robotic effects. The tuning knob lets you customize the calibration frequency, which defaults to AS 440Hz. And since all other sounds and instruments in our project are tuned this way, we'll keep this as it is. The stickiness knob lets you set the plugin's responsiveness to pitch changes. For example, if you find that during vibratos or sudden pitch changes the plugin reacts too quickly, you could try raising the stickiness amount for a smoother effect. There's also this scale editor, which is useful to easily set the plugin to our song's key. By default, the plugin will snap to all the notes of the chromatic scale, but we'll select F minor, as that's the key of our song. If we need to, we can also customize the scale by adding or removing notes. Okay, so let's do some pitch correction. As you can see, now we have both the correction amount and the correction
Ghost
speed fully turned up. As you can hear, this creates an extreme effect, but this way we can easily perceive the plugin's action. You can also get a visual feedback of the amount of the correction taking place, thanks to this meter on the right. Okay, so let's start working on our sound. Let's play with the amount and speed knobs until we find a sound that we're satisfied with. We'll bring the amount
Ghost
down,
the mirror,
since the singer is already pretty close to being in tune. The attack is still very fast, and we still hear that stepped effect as the singer moves across the notes. And although this may be a desired effect in some cases, we'll try to find a more subtle sweet spot for the speed knob.
Everyone's consuming, nobody's got a key. Spirit of the mind, tell me what do you believe?
We'll also move the stickiness up a little to avoid those more extreme pitch jumps.
You see me, first you feel the rush, then the toxicity.
Okay, this will do for now, but the vocal still sounds a little dry. Let's give it some depth by adding a bit of reverb. Let's select Entrack's built-in reverb from the effects list. Now let's pick a preset and then tweak the parameters until we're satisfied.
Ghost in the mirror, never say enough. Give me something I can feel, something I can touch.
Okay, that could do for now. Time to hear our vocal with the rest of our song.
Ghost in the mirror, never say no. Give me something I can feel, something I can touch. Everyone's consuming, nobody's got a key. Spirit of the mind, tell me what do you believe?